Imagine a world where everyone is healthy, strong, and full of life. Wouldn't that be freaking lovely? Well, believe it or not, we're actually slowly getting there. And it all starts with insulin resistance. And this video is all about that. It's actually a book summary of Why We Get Sick by Ben Bickman, and I'm going to be sharing the main points of what the heck is insulin resistance, how do you know if you got it, and how to avoid it for the rest of your life. Wait. So why do we even get sick in the first place? Well, to understand that, we have to rewind a little bit. All right, so for starters, insulin is a hormone. Its main function is to regulate blood sugar levels throughout the body and a bunch of other things. And the problem is when your cells become insulin resistant, they don't give a shit if insulin is high or low. They just keep doing whatever they're doing because they're resisting insulin as much as possible. And this is a problem because your body has to produce more and more insulin to get the same effect that it used to get. And there's this amazing quote from the book that sums up why insulin resistance sucks so friggin' much. Per se, it won't kill you. It's just a reliable vehicle that can rapidly get you there by causing other life-threatening conditions. All right, so now we know why we get sick. Now let's figure out if we actually have the main cause of all of this. There's gonna be a checklist right here. If you checked yes to one of these things, then you probably have insulin resistance. If you've checked two of these things, you definitely have insulin resistance and you should definitely contact your doctor. And as a quick little disclaimer, I'm not a professional. Please consult your doctor before making any serious decisions. And finally, let's make sure we don't get insulin resistance. So the main kind of idea of the book is instead of thinking as glucose as the hero, it's actually not, it's the sidekick. Insulin is the hero and the most important thing, and we want to be making decisions through that lens. So here's a bunch of recommendations that you can start applying to your life today. So for starters, we want to exercise more and be more active. That could even be going for a walk every single day or getting in the gym and making sure you do these compound movements. Especially, do not skip legs. It is extremely important. By the way, if you don't exercise or have fallen out of the habit, literally start as simple as possible. 5 minutes of exercise or even putting out your workout shorts is going to slowly build up positive momentum to actually have the habit in your life. Next up, food. There's this idea that a calorie is a calorie is a calorie. It literally makes no freaking sense. How is a calorie from a sweet potato the same as from a can of Coke? It's not. So instead of following calories, sure, use them as like a rough estimate of your stuff, but like ideally we want to be using our hunger levels as a guide. And then we want to think of our macros through this lens. So for starters, we want to focus on the highest quality animal protein that we can get. Ben Bickman is definitely a fan of animal protein, not really plant protein, but essentially he recommends, for starters, you want to get something that's grass-fed and pastured if possible, and we want to stay away from cured meat in general. It's usually filled with a bunch of preservatives and sugar. Then we want to fill our meals with fat. Keeping in mind, fat is not bad. Again, we want to be focusing on fruit fat and animal fat, not refined, crazy-ass seed fat known as PUFAs, polyunsaturated fatty acids. And then relative to carbs, we want to be using them on an as-needed basis. So for example, after a workout. And a couple other things about carbs, timing is extremely important. Ideally, we want to be consuming them at the end of the day with our dinner because it helps sleep out a bunch. And not to mention, we can be a little more insulin sensitive, to my understanding, at the beginning of the day. And also, you want to eat your carbs in a meal at the end of it. So after eating some animal protein or something like that, it's just going to offload the effect. And then instead of drinking your carbs, so juices and stuff like that, actually go out and eat them. We're going to get fiber that's going to be beneficial for us. And at the same time, eat more fermented foods. During the actual fermentation process, they use up the sugar to actually ferment. Next up, as mentioned, we want to be fasting in the morning. So we're going to have a prolonged period where insulin's going to be low, which is going to be beneficial. And we're going to skip that insulin sensitive state first thing in the morning. And finally, taking 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar at the beginning and end of every single day. Also, I want to throw a little note here. Yes, a lot of these things are lifestyle factors, but keep in mind, if these aren't working for you, please, use the various medical procedures that are available. The book outlines this in detail and explains the pros and cons of each one, so you can talk with your doctor about this and figure out what is best for you. Okay, so this might have seemed like a lot of freaking information. Here's my recommendation. To keep things simple as heck, just start fasting. Start 16 hours of fasting, 8 hours of eating. I personally eat my first meal at 11 o'clock and try to end eating by 7 p.m. And trust me, this is a lot more than just a trendy health fad. But beware, you can really mess yourself up, and I really did, being a dummy. So to make sure you don't make the same mistakes that I did, I made a beginner's guide, and you can feel free to check that out here.